Hi everyone, my name is Ray Prakash and welcome to another set on games and tournaments. Okay, so this is a very good set. I prepared it for unconventional cat pattern. Okay, so I told you of late cat is moving to more practical scenarios. Okay, they are making sets on more practical scenarios and IPL is obviously a very hot shot scenario right now. Okay, so we should know this concept, right? Camps concept of gambling, booking, odds, fractions, right? How it goes. Okay, it's a very interesting set. Okay, let's start. Let's see. In the recently concluded IPL, a lot of gambling were going on. In gambling, mostly fractional odds are used. If a bookie is offering odd of 20 by 3, okay, on a particular team, it means that for every rupees 3 that a gambler puts at a stake, he earns rupees 20, in addition to the original stake being returned to him. If the team loses, gambler does not win anything and loses his stake. Okay, on a particular day, 4 cricket matches are taking place. Match 1, RCB vs SRH. Match 2, KKR vs MI. Match 3, Kings 11 Punjab vs Delhi Daredevils. Okay. And match 4, RR vs CSK. I hope you know the full form, right? So an upset happens when a team beats an opposing team which had a better chance of winning, right? The bookie does not offer good odds on teams that are expected to win. Okay. Like a team with odds 3 by 8 has a better chance of winning than a team with 8 by 3 odd. The bookies has offered the following odds on different team. Okay, let's understand this set, right? Okay, so what it actually told is, yeah. So it told that if a gambler is putting or if a bookie is offering 20 by 3, so it means that for every rupees 3 we are putting, for every rupees 3 we are putting, we get rupees 20. Okay, rupees 3 we are putting and we'll get rupees 20. Fine, rupees 3 we are putting and we'll get rupees 20. So 20 by 3, let's say one odd is 20 by 3 and let's say another odd is 3 by 20. Okay, so here what will happen? If you put rupees 20, you get rupees 3. Right, just reverse of it now. Right, so obviously what a bookie will want you to invest on something, right? Or bookie will want that a team which has a better chance of winning, right? Bookie will put less on odds on it, right? Understand this point. If a team has greater chance of winning, right? So suppose a match is taking place between RCB and Mumbai Indians and MI, right? And let's say bookies has put a stake on this match of on RCB, they have put a stake of 20 by 3. So what does that mean? Simply, what does that mean? So it means that for a person putting rupees 3, you get rupees 20. So that is bad, right? Means RCB has lesser chance of winning. No. Okay. Because they have put such great odd. Because if you put rupees 3, then you get rupees 20. So this is done by bookies to get more customers, right? Because suppose RCB is a weak team, let's say. Okay, so if RCB is a weak team, so nobody wants to put money on that, right? So what bookie will do? He will put this kind of odd. You put rupees 3, you get rupees 20. Or they can put an odd of, let's say, 1 by 20 or 1 by 12. You put rupees, not 1 by 12. You can put an odd of 12 by 1. Okay, you put rupees 1, you get rupees 12. So people will like, okay, let's take some risk. If I am putting 1 rupees, I'll get 12 rupees. Okay, so that kind of situation only comes in bookie. No, bookie will have, bookie knows that these teams will have lesser chance of winning, right? For suppose in this match, for first match, RCB versus SRH. I'm just trying to explain this set, right? I've not moved to the questions part, just trying to explain this set. Okay, for this RCB versus SRH part. So bookies have put an odd of RCB 2 by 5 on RCB and they have put a odd of 15 by 2 on SRH, right? And the first match is between RCB and SRH. So RCB has put an odd of 2 by 5, sorry, bookies have put an odd of 2 by 5. That means you put rupees 5 and you get rupees 2. Okay, that's fine. In SRH, what they have done, you put rupees 2 and you get rupees 15, right? Now this is something suspicious here because you're putting only 2 rupees, you're getting 15 rupees. Why? Because SRH will have lower chance of winning, right? According to a bookie, he may or may not be right, right? But according to a bookie, SRH has a lesser chance of winning the match. And RCB has a more chance of winning the match. So that's why he's offering less profit on RCB. If you put rupees 5, you get rupees 2. Obviously, right, this is written that in addition to the original stake being returned to him. Obviously, right. That means if you are putting, if 2 by 5 is the odd, if you are putting rupees 5, you'll get rupees 2. So total you get is 5 plus 2, 7. Fine. So if you are putting rupees 5, you'll get rupees 2 extra. So total you get is 5 plus 2, 7, right? So that's why. Okay. Similarly, in this match, see in match 4. In match 4, just by looking at this, you can tell that which team has a better chance of winning according to that bookie. Okay. So RR odd is 13 by 4. CSK odd is 1 by 4. That means in RR, putting 4 rupees, you get 13 rupees extra. In CSK, putting 4 rupees, you get only 1 rupees extra. That means CSK has a better chance of winning, not RR, in this, according to the bookie, right? According to the bookie. So I hope it is clear, right? This set is clear, I hope. Okay. So now what we can do is, now it is written that an upset happens when a team beats an opposing team which had a better chance of winning, right? So like this fourth match. Okay. Let's say here, this fourth match here. Okay. So look at this fourth match. In this fourth match, RR versus CSK. So obviously, CSK has a better chance of winning here. According to the odds put by the bookie, CSK has a better chance of winning. Better chance of winning. Right? But if RR wins, okay, that is called an upset. If RR wins, that is called an upset. Right? Because RR had, according to the bookie, less chance of winning the match. Okay, but if RR wins, that is an upset. Okay, that is an upset. Fine. Okay, so obviously, right, so you just have to get this as fractions now. I hope it is clear. Okay, all the fractions, you can say in one language, you can directly say it. Like in one language, you can say it. More the value of fraction. Okay, more the value of fraction, lesser chance of winning, right? In that match only, obviously, put in that match, okay, winning in that match, right? So suppose in the first match or in the second match, KKR has put odd of 20 by 4 and MI 3 by 8, right? That means if you put 8 rupees on MI, you get rupees 3 extra. And if you put 4 rupees on KKR, you get 20 rupees extra. So which team has the more chance of winning according to the bookie? MI. So he is offering less money to you. So MI has better chance of winning here. So just you can look at the value of fractions, right? You don't need to do this much. 20 by 4 value is 5. So 5 is obviously greater than 3 by 8. Okay. So more is the value of fraction, right? You can do like this here. That not 5. You can directly write 20 by 4. So 20 by 4 is greater than 3 by 8, right? That means 20 by 4 fraction is more than 3 by 8, so it has a lesser chance of winning. That is what they want to say here, right? That 3 by 8 has a better chance of winning than 8 by 3 odds, because 3 by 8 means you are putting 8 rupees, you are getting 3 rupees extra. Okay, 8 by 3 means you are putting 3 rupees, you are getting 8 rupees extra, right? So for a bookie, he wants to put money. He wants you to put at least some money, right? Even you put, if according to him, KKR has a lesser chance of winning this match than MI. So everybody will put money on MI, that if I put rupees 8, I'll get rupees 3 extra. But the bookie wants to make profit. He wants to attract you. So what you will tell? Okay, on KKR, you put 4 rupees, you'll get 20 rupees extra if KKR wins, right? So bookie is taking this kind of risk. Okay. Now, let's move to the set questions wise. We'll see the set question wise now. Okay. See, this is the first question here. If a person puts rupees 400 at stake in each of the 4 matches, that is one team per match, what is the maximum possible amount that he can receive if there is only one match that results in an upset? Okay. So see, the main thing is here, the maximum possible amount that he can receive if there is only one match that results in an upset. Okay. So if he is putting 400 rupees at stake in every match, 400 stake. Okay. So, and he can, there's only one match that results in an upset, right? We have to see it, which match will give him upset, right? So, for maximizing it, right? Now, you have to maximize it. Okay. So, see here very carefully. Okay. For maximum possible amount. So, see in match one. Okay. See in match one. Match one is RCB versus SRH. Okay. So, match one is RCB versus SRH. Fine. Yeah. Okay. So, in match one, RCB versus SRH, right? So, obviously, if you see match one, RCB has a greater chance of winning according to that bookie. You agree, right? RCB has a better chance of winning according to that bookie. So, odds, he's offering odds of 2/5 on RCB, right? So, obviously, so what will happen basically? So, that means for every five rupees, he gets two rupees extra, okay? So, if he puts 400 rupees in the first match, okay, and if RCB wins, right, so he gets 2/5 of 400 as extra on every unitary method, right, on every 5 rupees 2 extra, so on 400, 2/5 of 400, right, this is the from the first match, okay, but given that there is only one match that results in an upset, right, so upset means it happens like a lower a team with the lower odd, that means lower chance of winning, beats a team with the higher chance of winning, right? That can happen in match one also, right? But you have to see, since you have to take the maximum possible amount, where the upset will help the most, okay? Where the upset will help the most, okay? That means if the upset happens in, analyze it, right? If the upset happens in the first match, so SRH odd is 15/2. So on every 2 rupees, you get 15 rupees. Fine, 2 to 15. On every 2, you get 15 rupees. Okay, extra. If upset happens in second match, so KKR has a lower chance of winning here. So if upset happens in the second match, then on every 4 rupees, you get 20 rupees extra. Right? So 4 to 20 extra. I should write like this here. Yeah, 4 to 20. Fine. If upset happens in third match, so obviously DD here has a lower chance of winning, right? So on every 1 rupees, you get 15 rupees extra. And if upset happens in the fourth match, okay, that if upset happens in the fourth match, then what happens? So RR here has a lower chance of winning, right? So RR 13/4. So what will happen? For every 4 rupees, you get 13 rupees extra. So since he has to take the maximum possible amount, so where we can do the upset, so you have to do the upset here in the third match, right? Because for every 1 rupees, he will get 15 extra. That is the highest. That is the highest among all three. So I want upset to be happens in 3, right? It's up to me, no? Because I have to maximize the amount, right? I have to see where I can do that upset and maximize and minimize those amount, right? So yes, upset can happen in third match. So he will get the maximum possible amount, right? So, okay. So first, second and fourth will go as per the bookie. As per the bookie means whatever bookie predicted, he has put the odd according to that, right? And that team is winning because in according to this question, out of 4 matches, 3 has to be normal winning and 1 has to be the upset. Okay. So in second match also, MI wins, right? So he has put rupees 400. So he will get 3/8 of 400 as extra. Okay. Now in third match, we had to make DD win, right? Because you have to do one upset, we have done it for third match because the maximum is getting. So he's putting 400 rupees and he's getting 15/1 of 400 as extra amount, right? So that normal language, for every 1 rupees, he gets 400 rupees extra. Sorry, 15 rupees extra. So for 400 rupees, he gets 15 into 400, that is 6,000 rupees extra. So 400 plus 6,000, 6,400. That's what will come here. Okay. And in fourth match, again, normal winning, right? Here CSK is expected to win. So CSK wins it. So 400 plus, okay, 1/4 of 400 you get as extra. You can simply add this amount, right? Now 400 plus 2/5 of 400 is 160, right? It is 160. The first becomes 560. Second is 3/8 of 400. Again, it goes 50 times. Okay. So it is 400 plus 150, 550. Here it becomes 6400 in third one and in fourth one it becomes 500. Okay. So it is 1110. 75/10, 80/10. So answer is what? Answer is 80/10. Total rupees 80/10, right? So under the given conditions, it is given that if a person puts 400 at a stake, okay, and upsets happen in only one match, then the maximum amount that person can earn is 8,010, keeping all the possibilities in mind. Okay, I hope you got it. Okay, now next one. Now, if there is no upset in any of the four matches and person X bet rupees 400, 800, 12,000 and 1200 in each match in any order, and at last he earned the maximum possible amount, and what was his total earning, right? So now he is putting 400, 800, 1000 and 1200 in each match in any order he is putting, right? So we have to see the order, okay? And no upset should happen, no upset should happen, right? So you can see here, see again. So if no upset is happening, the first match will be won by RCB on every 5 rupees. On every 5 rupees, you get 2 rupees extra. So for rupees 5, you get rupees 7. On for every 5 rupees, you get 2 rupees extra, right? On rupees 5, you get rupees 7. Here, MI should win if there is no upset. So on every rupees 8, you get rupees 3 extra, that is rupees 11. Here, Kings 11 Punjab should win 1 by 5. Okay. So that means for every 5 rupees, you get 6 rupees. And in third match, here CSK should win. That means on every 4 rupees, you get 1 rupees extra, that is 5 rupees. So to see here, which is the largest profit, right? So where it comes the largest profit, since I have to maximize the possible maximum amount, okay? Maximize that amount, right? So largest amount, like 1200, he should put on that match where he should get the maximum earning, right? So 5 to 7, okay, 8 to 11, 5 to 6 and 4 to 5. So you can do this in bit of percentage, right? It's fine. 4 to 5 means what is the percentage increase? 25% increase in the amount, right? You can simply do like this. On 4, he get 1 extra. So that means 4 by 5. So on 4, he get 1 extra. That means 1 by 4, that is 25%. On 5, he gets 1 extra. That is 1 by 5, that is 20% increase. Okay. On 8, he gets 3 extra. So 3 by 8 is 37.5%. Okay. And on 5, he gets 2 extra. So 2 by 5 is 40%. Okay. That means maximum profit, this is the profit, right? This is the profit I made. So maximum profit he is getting here in the first match, that is 40%. So maximum amount he should put in the first match, right? So again, his earning will be from first match, he has to put for maximum amount, he should put 1200 in the first match. So first match should be 1200 plus 2 by 5 of 1200, right? Extra amount is 2 by 5 of 1200 and it's given that in addition to the original stake, so you have to add 1200 also, fine, plus. In second match, 37.5% is the next highest profit percent. So next highest number is what? 1000. So plus 3 by 8 of 1000 plus 3 by 8 of 1000, okay? Now in third match is the lowest percentage, right? So lowest means what is the lowest amount available? 400. So 400 you should put in third match, right? So plus 400 plus 1 by 5 of 400 and 25% is the third largest amount. So third largest is what? It is 800. So plus 800 plus 1 by 4 of 800. This should be the maximum possible amount if he has to put these four amounts. Okay, in these four matches, he should put in these orders. Okay, so what is the answer here? Just calculate it. So 2 by 5 of 1200. So 1 by 5 it should be 240. So 2 by 5, 5 should be 480. So 1200 plus 480. 1680 plus 8 will cancel 125 times. So this is 375. So it becomes 1375 plus 80 plus 400, 480 plus 1000. Right? So it becomes 1680 plus 1000. 2680 plus 480. Is 3160 plus 1375. So 3160 plus 1375 should be 4535. That should be the answer for this question. Yes, right. It should be 45 and 35. Okay. So I hope it is clear, right? So again, a very good question. Question 2. Okay. Now question 3. Move to question 3. A person Y had a strong feeling that MI will win and he bought a stake of rupees 1500 on it. Okay. Also, he bought a stake of rupees 1500 in one of the teams playing match 4. What is the difference between the maximum and minimum earnings? Okay, what is the difference between maximum and minimum earnings, right? Now you have to see here. okay. So person wise, minimum earnings can be zero, obviously. Okay, if both his team, they were to find a difference between maximum and minimum earning, right? So minimum earning has to be zero. Minimum earning has to be zero, right? Because if both team lose, if both teams lose, then this is zero only. If both teams lose, right? So minimum earning is zero. Now to find the maximum earning, right? So he had put, he had a strong feeling that MI will win, and he bought a stake of 1500 on it. Okay. So what it could be is maximum earning. So for maximum earning, in two cases, right? For the match, he has put 1500 on MI. Okay. So if he has put 1500 on MI, so he has bought a 1500 on MI. So for maximizing his earning, we have to consider that MI will win the match, right? So MI will win the match. So how much it will earn? He will earn 1500 plus 3/8 of 1500. If MI will win the match, fine. How much it is? You can just cancel it out. Okay. So 3/8 of 1500. It will come in decimal. Okay. We'll calculate it at a later stage. Fine. Now, what is the difference between his maximum and minimum earning? So now for maximum earning, one more step. This is the first step. And also what he can do is he has put on playing one of the teams playing match 4. So he has put 1500 on one of the teams playing match 4, right? So since he had to maximize his earning, right? So we have, obviously here CSK has a better chance of winning than RR, okay? But since he had to maximize his earning, so his maximum earning will be when RR wins this match. Okay, so if RR wins this match, his earning will be what? It will be 1500 plus 13/4 of 1500. Okay, this will be his maximum earning. So this is the maximum earning, sum of these two. Okay, sum of these two. Obviously, this and this. So what is sum of this? Okay, so what is this answer here? So 1500 plus 3/8 of 1500. Okay, so 1/8 of 1500 into 3. So if you calculate it, you get to be 2062.50. The first one, okay, 1/8, it's easy to calculate, right? 1/8 of 1500, you have to calculate. So 1/8 of 1600 is 200 minus 1/8 of 100, that is 12.5. okay, that is 187.5. so 187.5 into 3 becomes 187.5 into 3 becomes 562.5. so 1500 plus 562.5, 2062.5, right? And plus 375 it is 375 into 13. Okay, so 375 into 13 is how much? Into 10 is 3750, and into 3 is 1125. Okay, so it becomes 4875. 4875 plus 1500, it is 6375. What is sum ultimately? 6300 plus 20, it becomes 8437.50. yeah, right, it becomes 8437.50. so his maximum earning is 8437.50, his minimum earning is zero. So what is the difference? Difference is 8437.50. that is the answer, right? So this is the case. So since that person has put a stake already on MI in second match, so in order to maximize his earning, MI has to win the match, right? We have to make MI win the match. Okay, and fourth one is 1500 match 4. So what is the maximum earning? If RR wins, then his earning is maximum, right? Now last question, fourth one. If one bets equal amounts on all the 8 teams, which results are the most favorite to him if there are 2 upsets? Okay, so if there are 2 upsets, right? Yeah, so question is, if one bets equal amounts on all the 8 teams, which results are the most favorable to him if there are 2 upsets? Okay, so now one bets equal amounts on odd 8 teams. So which results are most favorable to him, right? So what he wants to make his maximum money out of, right? So he has put equal amounts on all the eight teams, right? So a person don't know who is winning. So suppose I am putting 1000 here also, I'm 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 putting 1000 here also, right? So I'm putting equal amount on all the teams, let's say 1000. So what will happen here? So if there are two upsets, okay, so what is the best outcome for him, right? So best outcome for him will be if two upsets happen in match 1 and match 3, that is SRH winning the match and DD winning the match, right? Because these are the highest profitable matches for upset, right? Highest money making chance, because SRH will get on giving rupees 2, you'll get rupees 17, 15 extra. In DD, in putting rupees 1, you get rupees 16, 15 extra. So this is the highest profit, right, among all these four. Okay, so discuss in this last part also. Okay, so this is the highest profit. So it should happen with SRH and DD. Okay, so SRH and DD should win the match for sure. Okay, then what we can do is, okay, so we can from the options, we can look which option is for SRH and DD has sure to win the match, right? So first option doesn't contain SRH and DD both. Second option doesn't contain SRH and DD both. Third option contains SRH and DD. Fourth it doesn't contain, right? So fourth is the answer. C is the answer. You got it, right? Because if he has put equal amounts on all the 8 teams, so which results are most favorable to him? That means favorable to him is what? He wants to make maximum money. Okay. So when he'll make maximum money? When the upset, already two upsets are happening. Okay. That means lower chances, lower odds or lower chances, teams with winning of lower teams. Sorry. Already teams with lower chances of winning are winning, right? Two matches. So which are those teams where the maximum profit will come from where? So if I have to take two upsets out of these four, I'll pick for one and I'll pick for three, right? Why? Because this will give me the maximum profit, right? So here I'm getting the maximum profit. Okay. And this is the correct way to do it. Okay. So DD and SRH have to win the match. So option C contains both DD and SRH. So C is the answer, right? So I hope it is clear. Yeah. So this is very good set. Meet you in the next set of LRDA. Thank you for watching.